Hi guys, every year around this time of year, pieces of dust and other debris left behind by Halley's Comet collides with Earth's atmosphere and shoot across the sky. The peak of Eta Aquariids meteor shower, when the most meteors are visible, should happen before dawn on May 5th. So you should schedule your stargazing time between tonight, May 4th, and May 5th. Rates this year can reach up to 50 meteors per hour during that time. You'll need to get outside around 2 a.m. your local time. From then on, the rates will continue to increase until dawn. The meteors appear to originate from Eta Aquariids, one of the brightest stars in the constellation Aquarius. For people in the mid-northern latitudes, the radiant won't be very high in the sky. So if that's your location, you need to be in a dark sky site with relatively clear southern horizon to make out the most meteors. Yeah, too bad many of us are not down there by the equator. They'll have the best view, since the Aquarius constellation is more prominent in the southern sky. But even as far north as Miami, the view will be much better than it will be from New York or San Francisco, for example. So even though most of the meteors will be in the southern skies, they say there at NASA, even if you lay on your back and look straight up, you'll still see a lot of meteors. The Eta Aquariids are associated with Halley's Comet. Every time it makes a trip around the sun, yeah, it leaves a trail of debris that the Earth travels through. Here we have an image of Halley's Comet nucleus, the meteoroids, the actual dust grains that came off of Halley's Comet are about a millimeter across, and there's no chance that they'll hit the ground. Here on AMS meteors, they have a list of the different meteor showers. Here we got Eta Aquariids. You can pause this video and write down the dates for the different meteor showers if you wish. It won't be seen again until 2061. Every 76 years, it rushes around the sun and into the inner solar system, bringing new dust with it. All that cosmic dust has collected over the millennia, forming such a massive cloud that the meteor shower peak appears to stretch for many days. So if you can get out where it's real dark and give about 30 minutes for your eyes to adjust, yeah, you'll probably see something that you can go ooh and ah about. There at AMS, they say you may see no activity for 10 to 15 minutes, and then many meteors within a few minutes. So if you're a night person and you want to get out there at 2 a.m. and sit and watch the night skies until dawn, yeah, might be a good opportunity to see things. No meteors have been reported to AMS in about 2 days. Yeah, if you see something spectacular, send them your report. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you very much for your support. Once again, I got a new subscriber on my Patreon account. You know who you are. Thank you very much. Yeah, you can donate to my work. I have one person that donates 80 cents. And then there's more that donate anywhere from a dollar up to $25 every month. So I want to give a big shout out to my Patreon account supporters. Thank you once again for watching. Please let me know what you see when you go out between on the 4th and the 5th from 2 a.m. until dawn. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all.